All right, welcome everybody back to another Deepvue tutorial. Today we'll be covering the sales line, and this is a follow-on to the tutorial we did on the earnings line that we have in the Deepvue platform. If you haven't watched that one yet, I would highly recommend checking that one out first, and that link will be located down below in the description. Basically, what the earnings and sales line do in the Deepvue platform is they allow you to visualize the fundamental growth of a company right along with the stock's actual chart pattern. So here, the blue line is the earnings line here, and you can see the weekly chart of NVIDIA here. This growth and acceleration where the slope is really increasing on the earnings line, this is what institutions are looking for, and they're looking for that rapid growth, and then them accumulating positions is what creates this trend that we see in the market. So that's the kind of significance of the earnings and sales line. The earnings, of course, is the profits, but often with companies nowadays, we're not only seeing, you know, profit growth, or maybe we're not even seeing profit growth because we're looking at a software company where the emphasis is more on sales. That's why having the sales line is also important to, you know, for one, supporting the move of the earnings line where we're making sure that the earnings growth here and acceleration isn't just because of cost cutting or other kind of measures that can inflate that growth. But if we're seeing a similar sales line, that's showing that the company as a whole is growing and that sales line is leading directly to that earnings growth. And then on the flip side, if it's a company more like Amazon in the old days where they're focused more on growth at all costs, you can look at that sales line versus the earnings line, which gives you a better picture of that company's growth prospects. So let's go ahead and dive right in to how to add the sales line to your charts. And let's go ahead and hide the earnings line for the time being. And just like everything, we'll go up to indicators right here, give that a click, type in DV. You can see I've actually got it favorited here, but if we didn't have it favorited, we'd type in DV and then click sales line to load that up right onto our charts. So here you've got this teal line. This is our sales line. You can see the slope changing again, just like the earnings line was. And we've got the estimates over here on the right-hand side. As with every indicator, if we hover over it in the object tree and click the gear icon, we can bring up the particular settings for that indicator. You can change the look and feel, but first let's go over to inputs. You can change it from the actual value in terms of sales to the percentage growth rate if you would like that. Some people may prefer that representation. I personally prefer looking at the raw value and looking for that rate change just in the line. It's kind of an easier visual cue for me personally. You can also toggle off the estimates if you'd like. And also we've recently included the option to show the trailing 12 months version if you'd like to see kind of more of a moving average. That kind of representation can be helpful as well. I personally just like unchecking that and looking at that raw value quarter after quarter. With that settled, let's go over to style. You can change it from a line to an area, columns, histogram, whatever you'd prefer. Again, I personally like just kind of the standard line here, and that's pretty much it. And one more thing about both the earnings and sales line is they're only visible on the weekly charts because it's really about looking at that longer term trend that drives the stock's chart price. So if you're on a daily chart and you're wondering why you've got these loaded, but they're not showing up, it's because they don't show up on daily charts. You have to be on a weekly chart to see these particular indicators. So looking at this, you can see that we had an increase as, you know, NVIDIA increased. These are often highly correlated, and that's because institutions are valuing the growth and the company based on the sales and earnings. And that's what, you know, leads them to invest, build positions and seller positions. And often, you know, this creates that longer term trend that we then see in the stock's chart price. So here during the 2022 correction, we see it coming down actually here, but then we start to see acceleration where the slope is increasing quarter after quarter. This is a huge jump where we not only increase the slope, but we're increasing the value way over this prior peak back in 2022. And this is just showing that NVIDIA is really accelerating how much product they're selling, how fast they're selling it. And this trend is showing a lot of power and is likely to continue on into the future. So if we bring back the earnings line, you can see a very similar chart pattern. And this just shows you that, you know, these are very correlated. This is a more mature company. It's got both earnings and sales, and they're supporting one another. So this trend in earnings isn't just kind of a one-off thing. It's likely continue because it's driven by that longer term increase and acceleration in sales. And we've also got a nice kind of clean trajectory. You know, this earnings line, the sales line aren't all over the place, which is a lot easier for institutions who are looking to invest to kind of model. They're more likely to take up a position because they can more likely model out what growth projections should be in the future. And that gives them more confidence to go ahead and build positions. So if a stock, you know, is profitable one quarter, not profitable the next, you know, sales is up one quarter, down big the next, it's just not consistent and they wouldn't have as much confidence in that company. So look for nice smooth trends in these earnings and sales lines. And for companies that have profits, look for the sales growth line, supporting that move in the earnings line. So that's pretty much it for this video. It's pretty much as simple as that. It's really cool to be able to analyze the fundamentals, you know, not only in a table format like we've got down here, but also in a visual format right along with the stock's chart price and be able to, you know, see what that longer term trend that is leading institutions to invest or sell is right there for each company. So thanks so much for watching. If you did enjoy, please go ahead and leave a like down below. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Let us know your feedback, any ideas, any other concepts or indicators that you would like a tutorial on down below in the comment section. And definitely check out Deepvue if you haven't yet. We've got a special offer of 2 months for $39. You can access that by clicking the link popping up right now or down below in the description. And with that, I'll see you guys in future videos. Take care.